Good morning! Welcome back to my YouTube channel. Again, this is Mr. Santos Capilian Jr. Always wishing you a good day. Now guys, today what I'm going to show you is how I'm going to control this two-wheel drive robot through my, I have here my, this is my Bluetooth module. Okay, actually this is 8C-06 Bluetooth module. Okay, so what are the pins? So let me try to focus. Okay, so what are the pins in this module? Now we have here, let me see if I can. Okay, so I have here, okay, let me move it a little bit closer to my camera. Okay, so what are the pins of my Bluetooth? RX, TX, so as you can see the arrow, RX is the one that will try to send signal, then TX will be the one to receive the signal, okay? Now the other pins are ground and VCC, okay? So this will be our VCC. Actually, VCC is the power supply, okay? So you can provide 3.6 to 6 volts. So obviously, you can connect this to your Arduino development board. I'm using here an Arduino development board to control my robot, plus an this this is my DC motor controller, okay? So L298N, if I'm not mistaken, okay? Now, the pins, okay? So, first, provide power supply, ground and VCC, then RXTX. This RXTX is the one that will do the communication from your module, from your, this Bluetooth will be connected or will communicate to your Arduino through this RX and TX port. Okay, so your RX, okay guys, make sure the RX pin will be connected to the TX pin of your Arduino. Okay, so it's not like RX to RX. So RX to TX, then TX of your Bluetooth will be connected to the RX of the Arduino. Okay, so that is how you are going to make the connection. Now, guys, when you are going to upload the program or the sketch program in your Arduino board, make sure you will remove first the RX and TX connection of the Bluetooth module in your development board, because if not, it will give you some error, okay? So, just try to remember that one, okay? Now, guys, actually, I already uploaded the program in my Arduino. Okay, how these things will try to respond, or how my robot will respond based on the data or information received from my this Bluetooth module. Okay, now I will try to control the robot remotely through the use of my mobile. Okay, so first, before you can control the robot from your mobile, first thing you need to do is try to install an application on your mobile, okay? So, in your mobile, you need to, if you will go to the Google Play Store, try to look for Arduino Bluetooth controller. So, this is the application that I install in this mobile, Arduino Bluetooth controller. Okay, so just look for these icons. Okay, so this is the one I use, but actually there are several application that you can use, but for me I use this one. Okay, now once you download it into your mobile, then you can open it. Of course, the first thing when the first thing when you open your downloaded application, first it will look for the Bluetooth device. Okay, so make sure your Bluetooth is powered up so that it can be detected by your application. So once it is detected, then you need to pair it to your mobile. Okay, so this is my application. Okay, so just look for these icons. Okay, now Once your Bluetooth is detected, actually, as you can see here, that is my Bluetooth module, HC-06. Now it is paired, but I'm not connected because my Bluetooth is not yet powered up. So let me power it up, okay, just to show you how it will work. Okay, so let me power it up. Okay, as you can see, okay, so there will be some some LED that will be flashing there. So once it is paired, that flashing will stop. Okay, so let me pair it. Okay, let me pair it with my, where are you? Okay, let me pair it with my, okay, wait a minute. Just bear with me, okay. What is this? Okay, now I will try to pair it. Okay, now once you paired it, when it is already paired, you will see these options: controller mode, switch mode, dimmer mode, then terminal mode. Now I'm going to use controller mode. Now, but before you can use this controller mode, you need to configure this controller mode. Now, this controller mode is like a joystick. Okay, so as you can see, I have here the up, down and left and right key. Okay, now here I have also some icons here. Now actually I use this circle to stop my robot. I use this right key to move it forward, then the left key to move it backward, then up, I think I use it to steer my robot to the left, and down used it to steer my robot to the right. Anyway, I will try to show you, okay, since my robot is already powered up and my module is already paired to my mobile, now I can try to start it. Guys, actually I tried to elevate the wheels so that my robot will not run, because it's on top of my table. I'm afraid it will fall off my table if I will try to control it when the wheel is touching the table. So I try to elevate the wheel so that it will just try to run. Okay, so let me, okay, again. So let's try. Okay, now here. Okay, now this one is to forward. Okay, as you can see, now as you can see the rotation of the wheels, it will move forward. Okay, so I can stop it using this mobile. Okay, let me stop. Okay, wait a minute. There's some problem with. Okay, it's moving forward. Okay, so let me stop it. Okay, now as you can see, when I tried to control it through my mobile, it is stopped. Okay, so from forward, then you can stop it. Okay, now let me move it backward. As I said, this will be my backward, the left arrow. Okay, as you can see now, the rotation of the wheel is reversed. Okay, so meaning it will move backward. Okay, so let me stop it. Let me stop. Okay, now it stopped. Okay, now let me try to steer it to the left. Okay, so for steering it in one direction, you need to try to control the rotation of the two wheels. One of the wheels will move back forward and one of the wheels will move in the reverse so that it will go to the direction where the wheel is moving forward. Okay, so let me stop it. Okay, let me steer it to the other direction. Okay, the down arrow key here. Okay, so it will move in the reverse fashion. Okay, so this is how you are going to, let me stop it. Okay, so this is how you are going to control a robot through your Bluetooth module. Okay, now the next thing that I need to show you is how I program this. Okay, so let me pause it first so that I can focus you to the program. Okay guys, so what I'm showing you now is my program. Okay, actually I have here my variable declaration. So these are my variable declarations. So I'm connecting my L298 DC motor controller to this Arduino pin. So I have used this 8, 9, 10, and 11. Then for the enabled motor A, I connect it to 5. Then motor B connected to the 6 pins. Actually, I'm using the PWM pins of my digital pins. Okay. So actually, okay, now in the void setup, all you need to do is configure or specify the pin mode of each of your pins. Okay, so I'm using here, so my motor A, motor B, all configured to output. Okay, so actually I did not use this one, this pin. Okay, so as you can see in the void setup, these are the code. Okay, now let me go to the void function. Okay, so here, okay, so wait a minute. Okay, so this is not the program actually. Later I will show you one. Okay, so this is my program, sorry, that is not the program. Okay, so this is the program. Okay, so this is my program. So I have here some variable declaration that like Bluetooth val is the one that my Bluetooth will try to send to my Arduino. Okay, so then the program or the sketch program will respond accordingly whatever data received by my Bluetooth from my mobile. Okay, because we are trying to control the robot through mobile. Okay, the mobile will be the one to give the control signal to the Bluetooth module, then this Bluetooth module will pass it to the Arduino sketch program. Okay, so this is my program. Okay, so serial begin 9600. Okay, now in the loop I have here, if serial available, let's say the data is available from, let's say from my mobile, I send some data to the through the Bluetooth. When it is available, then my program will try to check what is the data. So if Bluetooth val is S, so meaning this one is to stop the motor. Okay, so these are the code. Okay, then else if it will receive F, meaning forward, so this is my forward, so this one will move my robot to forward. Okay, then else if I receive a B data or B character from my Bluetooth module receive a B character from my mobile, then it will try to move the robot backward. Okay, then else if I will receive an L character, then that is the one to steer my robot to the left. Okay, then if my Arduino receive R character, this is the to steer the robot to the right. Okay, so now actually what you will do is you will try to configure your controller, the application. So in that mobile, you can configure. Okay, I will show you. Wait. Okay, now as I said, okay, I already shown you the program. Now in this controller, you need to configure it. There is a configure icon here. Okay, so okay, so you need to configure this thing. So actually, so for the left or for the left button, that is will be B. So I'm considering once this left button is pressed, I will try to send a character, B character, to the Bluetooth module. Then that will be one passed to my Arduino. Then my program or my sketch program will try to check what is the value. Then based on that value, it will respond accordingly. So you have to configure all these control buttons. Okay, so left, so my left is my backward, then up is left, then right is for the forward, then this down arrow will be for my, I think, wait a minute, why it's not showing clearly. Okay, so it will, okay, wait. Okay, maybe I will turn up. Okay. Okay, so that is how you are going to configure it. Once you configure these control buttons in your mobile, then you are ready to test your robot. Okay, so guys, this is how you are going to control a robot through the this Bluetooth module. Okay, so let me recap. First, you need to connect this Bluetooth module to your Arduino board. Okay, then once it is connected, then you need to write some sketch program how this robot will work. Okay, how it will move forward, backward, steer to the left, and steer to the right. Then next thing you need to do, because you want to control it through mobile or remotely from a mobile, so you need to install an application in your mobile where you can control your robot remotely. Okay, guys, if you have any question, you can always put a comment. Then I am willing to share the connections, I'm willing to share the program. Just put a comment in my video. Again, if you are new to my channel, don't forget to subscribe. Please try to support the channel by subscribing. You can always click the notification bell. Then you can like and share the video. Once again, Santos Capilion Jr. will always end the tutorial by saying, God bless us all, and let's all be safe, and bye for now.